Hello friends, welcome to I Am Data Trends series. I am Shankar and today we have Vaibhav Banke, who is one of our Data Trend alumni. Currently he is working with Cognizant as a data scientist. So we'll understand his journey starting from his learning experience in Data Trend until he get into his dream job. Welcome Vaibhav, and first of all, congratulations team.
Okay, thanks sir. And it's my pleasure also to share my experience, what I got in last 1 year data science journey with the Data Trend Academy.
Great. Thank you. Yeah, we'll look forward for that. So before getting into the other conversation, we'd like to know from you your past education, the work experience, if you're working, or how did you start it, and a brief introduction overall. Could you please?
Yeah, sure. Myself, Vaibhav Babasu Banke. I'm from Kolhapur, Maharashtra. After 10th, I completed my diploma in mechanical engineering in 2014. Then I completed my BTech in mechanical engineering in 2017. So as per my education background, I got selected as a graduate engineer trainee in DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization, the unit gas turbine research establishment, where I worked in engine test data reliability analysis team. So as per this training experience, I started my new career in Cyient Aerospace Limited in 2018 as a reliability analyst, where I was responsible for the collection of the engine data and making the failure analysis of the same. So there was a future scope of data science, that is machine learning, to predict the engine failure. So I thought to upskill myself and learn this data science in order to upskill myself and to get somewhere else and get the dream job more than what I have now. Okay, so I searched online everywhere. So I got Data Trend is the best platform for me. So I learned the data science, everything up to the machine learning project phase. Then I prepared myself, and then as per the Naukri.com, I got a call about my skill, whatever skill I learned in data trend. Then I gone through interview rounds, and I selected in a Cognizant as a data scientist. So it has been 2 months from their joining.
Great. That's wonderful. I am really thrilled to know your past experience as you work in a DRDO research center, so which is really very good, I would say. So great. Okay. So
and there I got opportunity to learn many things with the DRDO scientist. That's good things for me.
Wow. Okay. So DRDO in which center? Bangalore center or some other?
Bangalore only. Bangalore. Yes. DRDO GTRE was there. That one Bangalore center, and previous my company Cyient Limited. This one also Bangalore.
Okay, so both are in CV Raman.
Currently, GTRE, yes, then Cyient, and then now Cognizant Pune. Now okay. In my home state, Maharashtra.
Okay, great, good, good. So coming back to the interview, right? So how many rounds interview you have to go through before you get your offer letter?
Actually, there was 3 rounds. Okay. Initially, based on my Naukri.com profile, they called me. I think HR was there. That person asked me about what experience you have and what skill set you have. Then after the screening, after 1 week, there was a technical round. Okay. And then technical round, another HR round. That was a simple HR round, means what the salary negotiation and all only. So this is 3 rounds only happened.
Wow, great. Very good. So on which topic interview was more focused on?
But the skill, then Omnical, they start from the very basic of the Python up to then machine learning. Very basics, what is the fundamentals, models and all. Then third one is the your actual project, on which project you are working and how you are implementing these skills on your real life project. So I have the engine data, I have the skill set. So I combine together and I told them these types of the work, and actually these types of work usually are doing in our client location, and I studied that one also. So that become easy for me to tell them that this is my eye skills and I'm using these skills here.
Okay, great.
And coming to the technical round, they more focused about on a very basic Python means they told me only just what is a list, what is a tuple, and how they differentiate means to from each other in which situation we are using. Then they given me two case studies in technical round. Means they told me that just take any business example, any business problem. How you will identify the business problem? Then for that, how you collect the data, whatever required for your to solve that business problem, and explain me the correct all the process which you needed as a data scientist. What you will do and how you will resolve that one. Just explain me brief about that one. Like this they told, and means complete cycle of this data science, like that they told. So it was a 1.5 hour interview was there.
Okay.
So it become easy for me because I already doing this work, so it become so simple for me. Just that not deal. Whatever I did there, so I just told there only.
So if you have gone through and if you are working on data sets and if you are practicing, as you said, right? So you did not feel any uncomfortable. You did not feel it's a challenging or a complex.
Uncomfortable for me.
Right? So it shows that since you have worked hard and it became easy for you. So there's no doubt about it. Great. So let me ask you, were there any specific algorithm, questions based on algorithms and things like that?
They told me that how you are selecting the model and selecting the model, which types of the models you are using in current data set, plus how you are on which basis you are checking the selecting the model, how you measure the performance of the model, and how you are deploying your model. That's it only. Then they not ask about any mathematical function behind that. They didn't ask me anything. Actual how the real-time practical example they want only.
So coming back to your learning strategy, so how did you chart out your learning strategy? So what was your plan, and how did you gone through this learning phase, and what was your strategy?
I already told you that there was a future scope for my current work as a data science. Okay, so what I need for the data science one, first one is mathematical and statistical background. Second one is you should know the understanding of the data, its importance of the data, and third thing is you should know the coding. Okay, and coming as I'm a mechanical engineering student, I know the mathematical and statistics well. Also, I want to add one point that I'm GATE 2018 qualified also in mechanical engineering.
Okay.
So mathematics and statistics was not a big deal for me. Mm-hmm. And data and its importance of data, it's how it can be used in future. That's I know. But only thing is I don't aware about the coding. So what I did, I just started initially through learning different channels of the YouTube. So I just clear my concept, basic concept, whatever means Python up to basic to intermediate level. So then I got realized that someone should be there in order to guide me, help me in a whole journey of my data science. Okay, because in my friends or any relatives, no one was there in order to guide me. I think in my friend list, I am the one who got this data science, entered in data science field. Okay, so what I did, I just searched. So I searched online which one is the best academy, and so that I can learn data science much. So I got. So because and there the data trend everything was and gone through this syllab this one curriculum and fee structure and whatever data trends are offering this internships. Okay, so I selected data trend is my best platform. Then while learning in data trend, then I think exactly 1 year before my first lecture was there. First session was there. Okay. November only started. November only started. So what I follow is in Saturday Sunday the live session was there, right? So I never miss the any session so that I can interact with the live support chat. Along with that, until I could get complete understanding of the all concepts, I usually used to watch again and again all the recorded sessions. Okay, whatever was there, so that I can understand all concepts thoroughly and practically also. And I did hands along with the while doing lectures, I prepared my notes. Along with the notes, I did hands-on on the Jupyter notebook, everything. So it became easy for me for telling whatever any years come while the doing hands-on also. Then after the machine learning, after Python, SQL, machine learning completed, there was a project phase was there in the data time, right? So I completed all the project without any rising any ticket for the any errors came across, because as a data scientist, you should handle these errors by self only, because in future no one will be come to, no will come and tell you, yes, this is your, and this is how you have to do, right? So I did whatever for sometimes I took it took 1 or 2 hours for me to get resolved some issues. Okay. So, but I never gave up. That's the only things I wanted to tell you. I had taken interest and I did. So whatever I learned from Data Trend, whatever I have the experience about the data and all, I've updated my profile in Naukri.com and I got call and I got selected. That's the thing.
One good, very good point you mentioned that, okay, so you never raise the ticket. So I'm really happy that the why I'm happy is because you are getting error, but still you are able to solve by yourself. And one more good point that, okay, data scientist, in future, nobody will come for your help, right? So which is a very great point, I would say. Really, I appreciate that. Yes, of course, so in our center, we also ask students to dive deep and try to understand. Yes, if you don't get, obviously, people are there to help you, but try from your side. So even if you don't understand, even if you don't reach the point what you are trying to learn, at least you will understand something else, right? So that is very
important. Yes, definitely.
So students,
and while solving the error, that is also an interesting point.
Right.
Searching here and there. That's a great thing.
Very good. Very good point, Vaibhav. Wonderful.
Reading so many blogs and all.
Correct. Yeah. So, yes. I think I was about to ask you, were there any mathematics or statistics related questions in the interview? As you already mentioned, there were nothing like that. But and also you mentioned that you had no problem with the mathematics or the statistics, right? So what do you think, how much one should prepare themselves, one should know about the mathematics or statistics when it comes to interview? What is your opinion on that?
Coming to the mathematics, initially you should know the basic of the maths, right? The interview, they will not ask you any derivation and explanation. When you will use this any particular concept, suppose in statistics we have mean, median, mode, right? The everyone know, but in which condition we have to use median, which condition you need to use mean, that's the thing only we have to understand first. Other things are we can work through the online also, you can read from the books also, these things only. Okay. First, clear the basics of the mathematics and stats, and the real-time use of these expressions.
Okay,
that's enough for that.
Okay, so what do you suggest to the students who are coming from non-technical background? Right. So, just want to hear from you. What kind of a suggestion you would like to give who want to jump into this space coming from non-technical background?
Okay, I would say that background doesn't matter for you to enter in a data science. But thing is, but you should know and you have to take interest over there. If you take the interest and you have to do, if you do carefully and focus by making focus over there, then definitely you can become as a data scientist. No doubt in that.
So, and
for me, it become easy because for me, it become easy because I am an engineering student. So some technical I have background, and whatever I do work in data. So I combined together and I expressed these things as a data science. So for me, it become easy. But if you are a non-technical background, you don't know anything, just start basic understanding, nothing worry about that one.
Great.
The things will get automatically happens.
Okay. So, and what kind of a support you received from a data train? I mean, so like you already mentioned, like you never raised ticket, you tried to solve. But other than that, how did the data train help you in terms of internship or in terms of electives and things like that?
Yes, I'm already mentioned that whenever you are to start in the journey of data science, there should be something that is the best platform, right? So data trend for me, data trend was the best platform where I learned everything, where I got the support, means in all way, starting means the staff of the data trend is super talented and over means good in order to clear your basic concepts in the data science, machine learning, in everything. Along with that, suppose I have any doubt and all in while doing in a live session, I usually ask to the live session support. That is the best help for me because on their itself, that all doubts will get cleared. Okay. Then another thing is the project phase, whatever the data trend providing, that's the best ever. In order, that means they are provided, means the data trend providing the project kits, right? This project that up to that time limit we have to complete, so you have to focus over there only and you have to complete this project. That's project phase is super. After then there is a internship, right? Where usually we can expose your practical things and you can do more hands-on in the in internship project. So also it will help for us for in order to show our this, we are not a fresher, we are experienced, we did these projects like that. It's really helpful for me also.
Great. You have taken full advantage of what we have given to you. So it's really commendable. So at last, I would like to hear from you. Want to give any advice to the students who are currently going through a data science course in the data train?
Yeah, as I already mentioned, means background is not matter, right? First thing. So take from your mind that yeah, I'm from this background, I'm this background, how I can start? Like that, this attitude should take mind. Only thing is where to focus. And another thing is curriculum, okay. Data science has some particular curriculum, right? So what we can find and we can do online with the best platform. So thing is, we have to find the best platform, best mentor, so that there should someone who guide to you there, this is a path, this is a track, these are the things, this is a way you can do these things. Okay, if the person is most motivated enough and he's taken so much interest in the data science, and believe me, he will definitely become a data scientist. I mean, say good data scientist, definitely.
Okay, thank you very much, Vaibhav. Definitely, you have thrown a light on many parts within the data science itself, right? So it's really, I think the way you have gone through this journey, really commendable. And coming your, especially background, definitely that would have helped you, I believe, right? So once again, thank you, Vaibhav, taking time and giving insights about your journey and
thank you so much to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you too much, sir, and for teaching to us. Very grateful everything and for giving me everything, support and everything. Thanks, data trend also.
Thank you. Okay, all right. So-